Welcome back, ladies and gents, to Face It TV. I'm DDK, and Risk is joining me as well for the commentary of this awesome grand final. We just had map one. It was domination from Kenny S, almost making the 40 bomb happen in a 16 round to 3 rounds play on Nuke. So MYSTIK starting off very strong, but we're moving into HELLRAISERS map, Inferno now for map number 2. What are your expectations, Mr. Risk?
That is... Yeah, that's a tough question, to be honest, because the Inferno could basically, as well as, of course, it is HELLRAISERS map choice. In my mind, it's pretty much everyone's map, because this is the most played map in the CSGO circuit right now. And I think every team, every pro team in the world have played this map quite a lot. So no one really has any weaknesses on this. So I'm kind of expecting, like, if Kenny S can make the difference, as he did on DE Nuke, we talked about this off-air as well, like, if he can go and pull out those crazy aggressive peaks, then I don't think HELLRAISERS has a lot to do, really. But if he doesn't, or if someone from HELLRAISERS steps up, then this could be a very close game, especially also Inferno. We've seen a lot of overtimes on Inferno over the years. And yeah, it could be pretty awesome to see this one go 15 to 15.
Yeah, I mean, it's funny because I just want to repeat more or less what we said off air, because we were both just excited little kids almost in the schoolyard, giddy for this game off air, just talking about it. And yeah, they're going into the knife round now, but definitely talking about Kenny S is interesting because he's definitely a key factor right now, because he's hitting his shots. He's feeling the, yeah, you know, the pace of his top level game. And again, I mean, do HELLRAISERS take this and go, okay, we know that Kenny S likes to take these, you know, the crazy random peaks. If he gets a good spawn, it can be kind of random. He goes for the best timing. Like, maybe it's apartments, maybe it's mid, maybe it's balcony, maybe it's banana, and he'll appear, quick flick shot, and then back away again. And so will they just wait and, you know, for a few seconds to throw off the timing for Kenny S's aggressions, or will they actually try to challenge him a little bit? Because it is actually a risk, and if Kenny S does lose, yeah, an AWP early on, that's a massive round turner for HELLRAISERS then. So it's like a really interesting dynamic, and I think it comes down to the age-old thing where it's like, as we see MYSTIK winning the knife round, they're going to say on the CT side. But I think it's the age-old argument where, like, don't overcompensate, just, you know, kind of try to play your game that you've practiced. I think that's what it's going to come down to.
Yeah, exactly. If you let your enemy dictate how you react, then you kind of already lost. So that is what they need to not do right now. They need to play their own game, as you just said. And, well, Kenny S, if you can't beat him, like, it's going to be a hard game because he can rotate anywhere on this map. He can play middle, he can play banana, it doesn't really matter. He can even, like, I've seen him go into freaking library and just shoot guys. It doesn't even matter, like, shoot guys through boxes on the side, because that guy could just play anything. And if he's warmed up, then it's going to be really hard. I'm not quite sure what they're going to do and what they have to do, but they have to bring better play than what they did on DE Nuke.
It's really interesting as well, because when you dedicate to the AWP, especially these days when it's harder to get value from the AWP as before, economically speaking, it's one of those weapons where it's like it can really make or break, especially when you're playing CT. It can either win you the half or lose you the half sometimes, because if you die early on with that AWP, you're all of a sudden in a situation on Inferno, like a 2-2 split situation perhaps. And that's really tough to deal with. That's really, really tough to deal with, it's because your buys are so much more expensive than the terrorists as well. And there's more value for you to have a sniper rifle than it is for the terrorists, who can group up, swarm. They can use the grenades to effectively deposition people with the sniper rifles and so on. So there's much more versatility and more possible play-wise for the T side. So it is really, really risky business on the CT side. So I'm very, very stoked to see what's going to happen. It looks like we did lose Kucha. Oh no, Kucha's there. Looks like we lost there he is, Angel's back even. So I'm sure we'll be kicking this off any moment now. Okay, we're going to go live into the pistol round for map number 2. Of course, this is match point for Clan MYSTIK, who won 16-3 on Nuke. And this is map number 2, of course. HELLRAISERS pick Inferno. Can they bring it back? They're starting off on the terrorist side as we move into the pistol round.
This is so important for HELLRAISERS. They need to get this round and gain the momentum right now, because they lost that first map. Now they need to get something done here in this round. This means so much, and everyone who follows CS of course knows that in every game the pistol round means a lot, because it means basically 3 rounds. But in a best of three, it also means a lot momentum-wise and confidence-wise. And right now, HellRaisers are down on confidence. They need to regain that by winning this round.
Yeah, certainly. And we're seeing some kind of commitment towards Banana, which is interesting. There are some little duels, skirmishes, not amounting to much. Beautiful nade from Hearts that did a lot of damage. And we can see that Clan Mystic hasn't rotated anyone yet. They're just keeping the two players. And nice. Look at that. That's beautiful stuff there. Angel goes down straight away. They rush into the site, though. They're committed. The rotation's coming in. And this puts a lot of pressure on HellRaisers. They're going to make it happen. And they've got to do it now. They've got to take the site straight away. They don't have time to plant. Here come the players, the rotators from A. They're moving around. However, HellRaisers dealing with it masterfully. Dozier locking it down there at that choke point. And now it's all on Kyoshima. Long distance, he's got the USPS in his hands, but I don't think hope is with him.
This is such a weird round, and it could still go weirder because, wow, that just happened.
Team kill, interesting.
And then Kiyoshima is like, he's 1v2, but they both have kind of low HP, so pots, and he wins this round, but they are playing this one cleverly. They are taking their positions. Doesn't even matter if he gets one kill, he can't make it. So this round is going to go to HellRaisers no matter what. But I was kind of wondering how they lost this. Of course, they did get allow the terrorists to go into the bomb site. Even though they got the first two frags, it was kind of like it came at a price because the terrorists were already in that bathtub position. They were ready to go onto that B bomb site, onto that A bomb site, B bomb site. Sorry, played a lot of CS Source recently, so the bomb sites are switched. But still, they allowed them to go in there. And that is something you just can't do.
They hit the rotation perfectly. And they were, like you said, they were stuck in pool. And it's like, usually if that happens, you kind of don't have anywhere to go. And exactly. But they kind of like exploded out of pool with a couple of headshots.
It was like, it was a round that was supposed to be over, but then it just wasn't at all. Everything just clicked really for HellRaisers there. Now, they do have a couple of AKs and Galils, one MAC-10 as well.
Yeah. It's like Adren with that MAC-10 probably wants to be the first man in, dying for the riflers, but is actually kind of backing away due to the smoke, putting on the delay. So they can afford to wait. It's an anti-eco. They can afford to wait out the smokes and go for it. And B is a great bomb site to go for if you're the terrorist side with those rifles playing against the pistols. You just have to get through that one choke point, and most of the situations from then on are kind of mid-range. So generally, it's not so bad, but here we go. Adren, first man with a MAC-10. Let's see what he can accomplish. They smoke down CT spawn, and he does fall to Hearts. But again, he just had the MAC-10, so it's not a huge loss. And you can see that's what they are playing for. They're like, okay, if Adren makes the frag, okay, that's great. We can move in. If he doesn't, we give away a MAC-10. Big deal.
We can rotate to the other bomb site, and right now they have a 4v3 scenario as one of the CTs will move in to that library. Kenny S starts us off with a nice shot onto Dozier. Angel will surely be picking off Kenny S here, and that will be the bomb plant. Double frag from Angel here. Can he go for the triple? He will, as Kiyoshima picks up Kucha. Still 2v1.
Hearts can do this. Head armor. Kevlar and the 5-7. The best pistol in the game, in my opinion. This could make the difference. They are pretty low, and look at that. He's gonna put himself to 1-on-1. Cannot do it though, Marklaw so low. But HellRaisers take it down. That was really nerve-wracking.
Once again, just a sick round by Angel. Even though it was only against pistols, he got those four frags. And really, when it mattered, like, once CT got into the bombsite, got a kill, then Angel just straight in there shot him down so he couldn't do any more damage. Picking up the important frags, even though it is against the eco, you don't want to lose too many members against that. And, well, they got the round, they lost four members, so it's not a perfect round for HellRaisers, but still, they just need every round now. They need the momentum, and they need the confidence, and they have not dropped any of those yet. So let's see if they can build on this and get some more.
Certainly, and I do love how they played that last round with Adren. I think that's another one of those really simple things that, you know, a top team does. That's very easy for, you know, a lower level team and a more amateurish team to copy. Like having Adren there with the MAC-10 and just sending him in first. And just seeing if he wins the one-on-one when he runs in against the pistol. That isn't really... Because also, if you haven't had the information whether they're stacking B, that gives you a lot of info. Adren might get loads of nades coming in. But as I'm saying that, we have the nades going over, sailing over the roof as HellRaisers move into the B bombsite, and Clan Mystic have to pull off a miracle with these pistols.
Well, they have three guys there, but it's not going to be enough. The firepower of HellRaisers is too much.
Adren,
the smoke. It looks so easy when you have the overview, the x-ray on, but normally that's just like standard, just spamming through, just taking a chance, and he hit that perfectly. That stack didn't really work out. Kirishima coming in though, picking up one. That's Angel going down. Can he come in for a second here with a CZ, the new pistol here? Not really doing much.
Double stack there in construction. Interesting stuff there. But here, Hellraisers go. They're evacuating the bomb site. They want to save those guns. They know that it cannot be defused at this point. And Clan Mystic, they don't get any exit frags with their little stack in construction. So very well read by Hellraisers to save their rifles and win the round regardless. But we actually see that Kyoshima was able to run in after they evacuated to pick up an AK. And so you managed to actually pull out an AK from that situation. So that's actually really nice, because the AK, I mean, only requires one bullet to make a kill if you connect into the head. And the M4A1S, there's so many heartbreaking situations where maybe you get the first dink, but then you get shot down. So big deal to have that AK. Kyoshima can turn the round with it. Let's see what he does, though. We have a buy situation for both teams. All rifles, no AWPs in sight. And quickly, we're seeing an apartment's move right now. A lot of movement over there. They're taking over apartments, our Hellraisers.
Yeah, one of the terrorists, of course, still in that banana. Just making some noise, making sure no one pushes in. And just carefully waiting here, the Hellraisers, playing this one out very, very carefully, which is exactly as they should do. So they're doing everything by the book right now. Really loving this from them. Just making their way into these apartments, just not skipping anything.
And they, until now, haven't given away any information. You can see that there's no rotation from B yet, but here they go, straight in on into the bomb site at the moment. There is Kyoshima defending with that AK, managing to spray down two. Here comes Kenny S. They're lining up for him. He's going to take down two as well. Angel's the last man standing for Hellraisers, but there is nothing much to do with 14 points of health and the AK-47. He's going to try, but he's going to fail. GMX getting the frag, and there you go. Clan Mystic getting on the board here. It's 1-3.
That was a really, really good hold there from Clan Mystic. I actually thought Hellraisers, they got into the quad area, and kind of when you get in there, if you get the first frag, then that's kind of the round. They got in there, and then they just got shot down completely. Because of that defensive posture and the AK from Kirishima, that just worked out perfectly for the CTs. And now we have yet another AK buy. Apart from Angel, who is on that deagle. He has been liking that deagle a lot, though. Also on DENU, buying that deagle a lot. Let's see if he can make anything happen with it this round.
Certainly, very curious to see what they're going to do here. This time they have two men on banana, keeping control of the CTs, not allowing them to go and peek, and if they do peek, making their lives very hellish indeed. And they are spread across the width of the map. Two men on banana, one over at mid with the bomb, and two around apartments. So they are just playing it very slow, playing it for map control right now, and limiting the information of the CT side Clan Mystic. And Kenny S, does he want to peek there? Not just yet, no. Not going to see anything when he does look around the corner, and still very limited. They don't really know what's happening at the moment. And we can see that Kenny S is actually floating over towards B. They have a read on B, it seems. So let's see if they are correct right now. And it looks to be that Hellraisers are making the move up banana slowly, and they're going to get ready. They have to go soon. There's only 30 seconds left in the round. And there, Kucha has been spotted. They've got to know. There's no time left in the round. It's got to be a B play. Here they are.
Oh, nice shot from SF, though. And round is still moving on. They need to rotate right now, but actually it doesn't really matter because SF just locks them down completely. Bomb is down, and SF can just hold this one. GMX, though, comes in with the help. Can the terrorist come in right now? Kucha with the triple kill right there for Hellraisers. And now, all of a sudden, it's a 2v2. I actually thought SF had the hold right there. He got the first two frags, then got shot down. One HP on Markolov, though. Kucha, can he make the ace?
Here we are. Kyoshima trying to push in towards Paul right now. He's got Markolov on the left. He's got Kucha on the right behind Coils. There he's going to spot Markolov. But Markolov, how does he find the kill? Markolov will go down. 19 health left on GMX as they save the round. And Hellraisers, against all odds, managed to actually get that bomb down. That's a big result, all things considered. So, interesting round. That went right down to the wire. And we are going round for round at this point. It's now 2-3 as Clan Mystic managed to actually win that one. So this is pretty good. I mean, so far they haven't really had an economy where they're happy to just throw an AWP onto Kenny S. Yes. Yeah. I'm sure everyone's waiting for that to come into play.
Yeah, chat is waiting patiently for that AWP to come into play. But also I'd like to touch up on something that you said earlier, so we have this eco round probably going towards the apartments of the mid, will be just sprayed down. Let's just wait and see if they can get anything out of it before I go into some long and incentive point, as Markolov will be the last man standing with 51 HP bonus down. So this is pretty much done and dusted as he goes down. What you pointed out in the first map was that Hellraisers, they kind of relied on their like individual plays, and that's exactly what we've been seeing so far on this map as well. We did see Angel coming in with the four frags in the first round. No, not in the first round, but another one of those rounds. And then in the round before that, that was Kuchia right there going onto that B-bomb site, getting the triple, getting the entry. And it was his individual play that kind of gave them the chance of getting the round. Then they failed afterwards, but still, it's kind of like their individual play is what is carrying towards the round. It's not like the team play, the strategies, the good smoke, flashes. Oh, what?
Kenny S getting aggressive. He doesn't spot anyone in mid. Goes for the peek on second mid. Timing was bad. Bit too frag hungry there. Loses the AWP. His teammates have to save the day. It's SF and Hearts, the two last men standing for Clan Mystic, as Hellraisers are all over the bomb site right now on A. They should be able to get the bomb down. But wait, where is the bomb? It's so far away over in apartments. This gives Clan Mystic a lot of time, and they may even be slightly confuddled as the bomb isn't going down yet, but here it is, finally going to get planted. And you can see that Clan Mystic are just taking it super slow, waiting for that bomb plant so they 100% know what's going on. And they do have time for this retake, but it's going to be very, very hard indeed. They have no idea where the three players of Hellraisers are exactly, but they should have a good guess. Looks like they're going to go for a save, actually, to just take the AWP and save it. Give that to Kenny S, perhaps, at the start of the next round.
Yeah, I was kind of like, yeah, Kenny S is not going to do anything here, but they just got taken out completely. The bomb was so far away, and the round will go to Hellraisers. They're using the usual spot in the corner of the pit to save their weapons, kind of like defying the laws of physics and explosions. Being in that corner doesn't really make any sense, but it works anyway, and that will be 4-3 for Hellraisers.
What we saw there was kind of what, you know, we were talking about before, where, you know, the AWP player can be very make or break if he's playing in the way that Kenny S does. And was, I mean, Kenny S went for the, like, he started off standard, you know, went for the peak. His timing perhaps not good enough to do anything more than that. But then after he didn't see anything on T slope, he was thinking, okay, there must be movement on second mid. He was right, and they're right in his face. So kind of an aggressive move. I mean, you can call it a mistake, a risk. I don't know, but Kenny S really cost his team the round there at the beginning, and that's how it can go. And we're on a 3-4 round score as we see Hellraisers right now just kind of thinking about whether to go banana or not, waiting for the smokes, and after the smoke dissipates, they're going to make the call.
Yeah. Kenny S, he does this a lot. He makes a difference for his team, and right now he's not really playing his best game, as we saw in that duel we talked about earlier. On Nuke, he did the exact opposite, and that is kind of the difference he makes to the team. The rest of the team are very talented and very good, but if Kenny S misses his shots, that, what was that for Marco? If Kenny S misses his shots, it's going to go bad, but here we go, push coming in. Kucha with that AK surely will be taking Hearts out. Could he go for that second on those calls? They don't know he's there yet, but double fire coming in. Kenny S with a nice shot onto Kucha. Doja will be taking out GMX as he comes in from the banana. That will be a 3v3, surely here. There we go.
So post-plant's setup right now is not too shabby from Hellraisers as they try to defend here. Clan Mystic are going to go in for it. SF creeping around the corner. He takes down one, looking for the second. It's got to be Kenny S who takes the trade. Kiyoshima chiming in for the third. Dozier, last man standing here. And he gets locked down on banana by Kiyoshima. And there goes the defuse. Clan Mystic with a surgical retake there. The precision was wonderful, and they keep the AWP alive. It's a good situation all around. So now Kenny S has that AWP. I'm just going to jump over to his... Okay, he's kind of spawned in the middle there, so not a great spawn for mid, but let's see what he does with his AWP. It can always be very telling.
Yeah, it's kind of telling for the round what way Kenny S is going to go here. Looks like he's going to go for that mid-pick, maybe, or maybe the apartments. Let's have a look.
Mid-pick, they're doing the three-man push down mid, which we've seen from Titan, although usually it's, I think that was three rifles when Titan did it. And that is super effective. Just they take so much control of the map here. They can split off the players on second mid and nice banana and Kenny S and Hearts. They're locking it down right now.
Yeah, they have so much map control. It's actually funny, like, how cramped up Hellraisers are right now. And let's see, GMX actually fails to see the second guy that Hellraisers was hiding behind that shrubbery onto those apartments, and it will be a 3v4. So advantage for Clan Mystic right now, but still, we have seen Hellraisers turn rounds like these around. Let's see if they can do it again.
Yeah, they managed to retake the mid. That was the first massive mountain to climb, and they achieved it, but the cost was losing an extra player. I like Clan Mystic's presence of mind to like fall back out of mid when it started to get a bit too chaotic and they couldn't control all the variables anymore. They just fell back and they cut their losses, which was just GMX getting dropped. But here goes Kenny S. Oh, is, and there it is. Frag nice. Going to come for Kenny S as Dozier tries to test the corner. And now Hellraisers are committed to a B player with 20 seconds left in the round. There's nothing else left to do. Oh, but there is a player around sandbags. Genius.
Because you're not going to expect a player to sit at sandbags with like 20 seconds to go. You're not going to expect him to sit there. You're going to expect him to sit in the side or something. And well, they just ran straight past him, and that became their death. Hellraisers right there. And that will be the fifth round for Clan Mystic, who, of course, will be looking to get an advantage here in the first half. They are on that CT side. But yeah, right now it's going to be an eco from Hellraisers. So shouldn't be too much trouble.
Oh, here we go from Kenny S. Look at it. This is going to be it. The balcony shot, the flick shot, and he makes it happen in Kenny S. Star. He goes for the second, misses it. Is he going to bite off more than he can chew? He's against the pistols, so he felt like that wasn't a huge risk, I imagine. And that's always a good start to the round. And Clan Mystic now getting the smoke down on mid, allowing them to push for, second mid. And Adren, look at this. Beautiful spam from Adren. That's perfect. Perfect counterplay.
Dosha is in behind them right now. They know something is up. Dosha surely will land his headshot. This guy's coming around through Arch, but he will grab this M4, and that can mean the difference in this round right now. Dosha has that M4. Can he go for that frag? He goes for the frag, but will be taken down by GMX. Kucha answering back, though. Bomb is on a Dren still. Kucha here with the M4. 1v2 currently in on his own there, and will be taken out, and that should be it, really. Shot down. Kenny S with another frag.
Yeah, and very chaotic there. Very chaotic indeed. Just running straight up apartments, that was the one way to really kind of counter that strategy of pushing mid, taking control. And it didn't work out for a bomb plant, unfortunately for them. But it is very interesting right now. I mean, we cannot count Hellraisers out. They're doing a really good job, even though Clan Mystic are starting to run away a bit with the money and momentum. And we're seeing Hellraisers really struggle for money now. They've got this buy, but right now they are very broke. No player with more than $100 on his side. So Hellraisers, they really need to get at the very least a bomb plant here, or they are going to be experiencing a lot of pain. And Hiyoshima might just find Dozier. And this is really important, putting the stop on Hellraisers over at the apartments. They cannot take control of that now because Hiyoshima is guarding it, and GMX guarding the balcony, shutting down this play, this mid-apartments play, completely decimated. But Markov and Kucha, the last two men standing for Hellraisers, are trying to save the day, and SF going to drop Kucha and Markov, so silencing them both. Very good stuff there from Clan Mystic, getting the save at the end. But Hellraisers, where is the answer for them? Where is the weakness in Clan Mystic's defense? What can they exploit here?
Yeah, it seems like the explosive players were just so that when they got those two frags, kind of made it all a little bit chaotic, running into middle and making that explosive play happen. That kind of seems to be the way to do things. The problem is that Clan Mystic knows what's going on. They have the correct positions all the times. They have the rotations happen. So it seems like they're quite ready for what Hellraisers is bringing to the table. And I'm not really sure what they should do right now. It's going to be a spray down, surely, here.
Yeah, all blind. Yeah, all shielding their eyes. I love that, by the way. I just love that they put that in the game. It's just
lovely
gorgeous.
Animation there.
It's really gorgeous.
Running blindly.
And that's always the question as well. Is like, were you blind? Were you blind? I remember that. That's like one of the most asked questions when you're playing Counter-Strike before that animation came in. And we move 8-4 now on this half. So Clan Mystic are doing really, really well. And Hellraisers, like you said, that explosive play has yielded some results, but it's always very tricky. And the problem is that Clan Mystic are so strong in apartments, and that's really where it gets shut down most of the time initially. And they do sometimes get up mid, but because they have no support from Boiler and apartments, it just falls to pieces. Kenny S might just get caught, 6 health left. Angel's gonna go for the follow-up, and here comes GMX with the save. And the smoke down there from Kenny S will stop any push. So Kenny S barely escaping with his life there.
So they know that Kenny S is low on HP now, and he has to play defensively. And maybe Hellraisers can take advantage of that, but GMX right now in a very aggressive position. He could get a frag right now, but not really happening for him. Very close to a kill coming in from either side there, but no one will do any damage. And the terrorists are still left with a question, where should we go? It looks like they're going to go towards A. They are kind of gearing up for a runner. Bomb is going to be picked up. There are three players on the B site right now for Clan Mystic. This could be the round. If they get the entry, if they get that bomb down, I'm pretty sure they have the experience to lock down that post-plan scenario, but they're not really fast about it.
This is so interesting, actually. The movement. Oh my god, they're lining up for GMX. He gets the double with the spray of the M4A1S. He might just get the third player as well. Wow. Jumping around the corner, he might get the fourth one too, jumping out of the apartments. And GMX, oh my goodness, he's going to finally get taken down by Adren, but he's done so much damage. Dozier in the pit, good position. He's managing to try to smoke down small pit, but Kenny S will take him down first. So this should be a very simple retake. Adren, can he do this? No, he can't. But that was really interesting, though. I mean, because they managed, after Kenny S got aggressive, went down to 5 health, he went straight to B with that low health. And the two remaining players in A, they just decided to sit in pit, and it was like a really, really nice spot to have to be able to defend A from, because they can cover each other really well. You don't always expect two players to be in pit. It's a very hard place to kind of root players out of, and they were going for it, and then they stopped. Hellraisers, they stopped at mid, and then Clan Mystic didn't know what was happening, so they moved the players out of the pit, and then they got really lucky. So it's really interesting how that turned out, but Kenny S going aggressive here, and he's gonna get taken down for it.
That's not good, but luckily for him, his team steps right back up to the plate. Takes two frags there, Adren and Markov going down, both of them. And now it's all on Angel and Kucha. 2v4, and they have a mountain to climb right now. Bomb is on the back of Angel, though, and they are both on full HP, but still, it's going to be very hard for them as Angel picks up the first one. That is a start.
Here we go, yeah, them step. Making their move into the B-bomb site now, and this is it.
To rush in.
This has got to be it for Hellraisers. They've got to execute. Nice. And there is one. There's a trade coming in. It's a 1-on-2. Kucha is the man to make the difference for Hellraisers. He's got a man approaching him from construction. He's got one approaching him from pool. Can he deal with the pressure? He folds as GMX guns him down with the M4. And there you go. Another round going to Clan Mystic. This is not a good look for Hellraisers, who on their map pick are struggling desperately. And Clan Mystic, they took down the first map, Nuke, 16-3. And this is for that first place. This is for that $1,300 that number one gets. And it, so far, it's looking like it's got Clan Mystic's name written all over it.
I really love how Clan Mystic plays every single round that they're supposed to win exactly perfect. They're not letting anything come down to chance or just an insane clutch coming in from one of the players on the other side. They're just playing that 2v1s really perfectly. Right now, taking some damage, delivering some the other way, Kuchum 23. But let's see, no kills awarded to anyone just yet. Just a bunch of damage all over the map. Right now, presence from the terrorist, kind of all over the map as well. Apartment and mid, covered up, as is the banana area. Adren trying to do damage and trying to locate these counter-terrorists. Kenius in the apartments might face some action very soon, holding that little gap with the AWP.
Yeah, and we have three men over at B. So this is really interesting because Hellraisers have pushed the players back, and we have a player moving very close to Sandbags. Hearts will take down Adren, and that should tell them now that it's an A play. They've got to know GMX is going to duck out of that corner, take down two players instantly. He's going to get the third two. Markloff falls, and it's just Dozier that remains at the moment as Clan Mystic just clean up. This is the last round of the first half, and Hellraisers, oh my god, the pistol round, the pressure on the pistol round, oh my god.
So much pressure on Hellraisers, right? Recently have joined this organization. Not quite sure if it's just for Katowice or if it's like a long and stable relationship they're going to have with these guys, but they have just joined up with Hellraisers. And even though, of course, their first tournament is going to be Katowice, this is kind of like an experience just to show off. Like, this is who we are. We're going to win this. We beat NIP. We can beat this Clan Mystic team as well, win this tournament, and we're going to be ready for Katowice. But right now, it's not looking good for them. It's not looking good at all. And they have to win this pistol round. Absolutely have to. Or else it's pretty much over if they don't win this. Of course, they are a team that can come back at any time, but they need this so bad.
Oh, no. It's a bad start for them. Adren going to get picked off over by the car. Kenny S putting the bullet straight through his head with the Glock. And now they've got to try to be drastic here because Clan Mystic circling around. to get the bomb and make that play on B. And and Hellraisers, they're all regrouping towards A for some reason. And the bomb's going to go down on B very shortly. And they seem convinced that it's A, which is very strange. Maybe they're seeing something different than we are. Of course, we have perfect information as the spectators. But still, this is very interesting. And now they realize that we made a really bad call this round. It's going to have to come down to a ridiculous save. Dozier has the only kit. So this is possible for them to do this. But it has to be a miracle. It has to be something incredibly magical. Here we go. Kucha moves into construction. Got two players to face off with. Nice. Finds the first headshot on Hearts. This is good. They're gaining ground, pushing into pool. Kiyoshima there.
Clock.
Oh my god.
Nice stuff from Kiyoshima there. Double kill from him. And Hellraiser's failing to get onto that bomb site. Just being shut down completely by Clown Mystic. Didn't even have time to use that incendiary grenade, which was one of the players on the Hellraiser's side. Just got completely gone down before anything could happen. And yeah. 12-4, man.
So MIP need to look at these demos because basically, let's just look at what we had before. When Hellraisers played MIP and they won against MIP, they won Inferno 16-13. So it's really, really close. And on Nuke, they made it an 11-16 game against MIP. They lost 16-3 against Clan Mystic. So this is very interesting. So Hellraisers seem to be a very different team one day to the next, perhaps, or Clan Mystic just have their number. Whatever it is, the pressure is massively on right now for Hellraisers.
I think it actually really comes down to Clan Mystic knowing exactly how to handle these Hellraisers players, because we have seen in the individual actions, they know what to do. And right now, Dozier just hiding behind this corner. And will he get something for his troubles? That's the question. GMX on the other side of it. Let's see. He will not get the frag, and that will be the entry signal. Angel, though, coming in with that 5-7, going for that triple knot.
Nice.
Sparkle of steals it away, but still, nonetheless, it is impressive using that underhand throw. Going for that second, that third coming in from Angel. Nice stuff from him. And SF will be all alone. Bomb is down. 1v4. Three rifles to face.
That is a wonderful smoke there. And here we go. SF's going to try to make it happen with four players left. Can he do this? It would be amazing to see. They all have picked up the rifles that were dropped by his team. Look at this, SF trying to. I think he's going to go for the sneaky player, but now he's just going to go for the plant, get that money guaranteed for his team. And now they all swarm. Four players. SF, it's a shooting gallery. Takes down two, takes down three, but it's going to be Markov who saves the day. And that's actually quite a big deal because they had rifles. That was a situation where, let's say, maybe three of them could survive, and that would have been a really, really nice implication for the economy in the long term. And that's something that Hellraisers really need. They need every edge they can get right now. Because, I mean, what a statement Clan Mystic are making right now in such a, with such a dominant performance in this grand final against Hellraisers, who did so well against NIP.
I think this is the last online tournament before Katowice, and Clan Mystic going ahead and winning this tournament that has teams like Hellraisers, like NIP in it. It's such a huge statement because this is a team that even I did not expect to. Well, I expect them to do well, but I don't expect them to do better than NIP and Hellraisers well. And right now they're doing it. They're ripping Hellraisers apart. Hellraisers did beat NIP, so my mind is boggled, and I'm so impressed by these French guys right now. I'm so happy for Kenny S because it seems like he has found his home now. Very, very happy to see that. And 12-5 against Hellraisers here in that second map is just talking its own clear language. Right now, they're on an eco, though, but still.
Yeah, they have control of apartments right now. They got a player in boiler, but this is going to be very tough to make the pick. The smoke does dissipate. Kucha tosses in the grenade. I think they've kind of pegged onto what is going on. They just need to know, get that one last bit of information to know for sure. But actually, Clan Mystic, they're going to fall back now after making noise, after pushing Hellraisers back. You can see very defensive posture from Hellraisers on A because of how close Clan Mystic were creeping. But now they've circled all the way back. They're going to commit onto B with those pistols. This is every single round for them is incredibly important. And here they go. Oh, they're going to run straight into the fire of those rifles as they approach through B onto the site. And it's Angel in the back. Can he get the spray down that will save his life? And so far, he is doing it. And Kucha comes in from behind, tying it all together, wrapping it up with a nice bow and taking the round. So HellRaisers able to do it there?
Still two frags, though, from Clan MYSTIK right there. Did invest in one deagle, which guaranteed them the insert frag, but still two frags is okay. It's not bad for Clan MYSTIK, and they are in the lead 12-6, have the double amount of rounds as their opponents, and now are buying up. So if they can win this round, they're pretty much going to just punch a big hole in the confidence of HellRaisers, the newly found confidence after that round win.
Definitely, and look at this, they're making their move up second mid. Probably want to take over apartments very soon.
Or... double push on Banana, though, from the CTs. Not pushing too far. Maybe going to do that now with the smoke coming in. Nope.
But they should have eliminated the variables here and realized that the players have to be around second mid slash mid. Yeah. They've basically worked that out now because Clan MYSTIK, they haven't shown themselves on Banana, and HellRaisers have pushed Banana. So they got the information now. They know exactly how to set up, and they should be rotating now, but the Banana players can flank. But here they go, moving into Kucha, and here goes the rotation as Kucha locks down CT Arch, and that's going to actually convince HellRaisers to, or rather Clan MYSTIK, to kind of reconsider what they're going to do. They're actually moving back. Kenny, yes, with the bomb alone at CT Arch. I think that was maybe weird. A mistake, or is it?
This is an extensive kind of fake as he runs away. He could very easily be caught off guard there, but yep. He survives nonetheless. And right now it's pretty much a 4v1. Two rotations coming in though, but only one CT on the bomb side right now. As GMX runs in, smoke is down towards CT spawn. They need to get this frag right now. Need to get in. Adren will pick up one.
And here's Kucha's the bomb side. Managing to get the spray through the smoke. That's very well played. Two players left, Kyoshima and Hearts for Clan MYSTIK.
Five
now,
seconds.
There is no time indeed. Angel going to take down Kyoshima and Hearts as he tries desperately to get that plant, but he's not going to be able to do it. So we have a 12-7 situation. The HellRaisers are bringing themselves back into this game.
Yeah, it looked very sloppy, the play right there from Clan MYSTIK. Didn't really look like they knew what they were doing. Kenius was caught in... in the arch there with the bomb, and he was like, okay, we're going to run towards B. I better flash this area and make it like a fake, but it was so easy to read. HellRaisers did have those two rotations coming in, and even though they only had one man on the bomb side, he managed to get that first kill, and that's all they needed. They could hold it down and get that round and gain some more confidence, which is so important right now. Another eco coming in from Clan MYSTIK, and if they can get this one, they're on a 3-round roll. And it's going to make their life a whole lot easier, both money-wise, but also confidence-wise.
But look at this. Oh, the quick frag by the CZ75. It is so powerful. Dozier feels the pain over at Apartments. And now what are Clan MYSTIK going to do with this? They're going to synchronize a push onto A, but they're being a little bit slow here, and they're allowing time for the rotation. The smoke goes down. This is really tough. They're going to go through anyway. They are committed for this play. Diving in onto the pit. Markov defending immaculately with a triple.
Oh, beautiful.
And now GMX going to fall as well. HellRaisers bringing this back. Markov put to the test. He passed with flying colors as Hearts remains the only player left. And it was a wonderful attempt for the pistol. I do like what Clan MYSTIK did there. They did give themselves a pretty good chance to at least get a couple frags and maybe a plant in the chaos. But definitely that we saw excellent execution there from HellRaisers players as they locked it down. They worked out what was happening too very quickly. So the full buy from Clan MYSTIK now.
This is a very important round because right now the stakes are high. We're in round 21. And both sides here with a little bit of money to spare. HellRaisers a bit more than their opponents from Clan MYSTIK. But still, we see $1,200 on one of the CM players here. Right now, they're pushing up towards middle. Who's going to be the victor?
Markov is making the initial frag there, which really hurts Clan MYSTIK massively, thinning out their ranks. Luckily, though, for Clan MYSTIK, they have Kyoshima and Hearts, who are thinning out the ranks of HellRaisers, securing the plant now. Angel coming through the library. Kenny S says no. No approach for library for you. Angel going to get taken down. It's just Adren left. He goes for library. Kenny S having to reassert himself once again, saying, seriously, guys, library is off limits. And we go 13-8 now as HellRaisers really bringing themselves back in. And we're not seeing any AWP play at all from HellRaisers.
Nope.
Which is, is there any insight you have about that? Why do they
actually
choose not to go for it?
Not really, though. I would love to be able to come in with a really, really good remark, but actually I don't have any.
Yeah, no, it's an interesting one. I mean, you have more freedom of movement without the AWP, so I guess it's just how they're feeling. It can be an emotional choice sometimes.
Yeah, exactly.
It is that a big risk.
Yeah.
Here they go. They're actually just going to go for it. Straight up B-Rush. Here we go. We don't see this super often. And they're just going for it. Adreno locking it down. And they're still trying to force their way in here. But it's proving difficult.
Oh, wow. Nice shot, though, from Kenny S as Angel tries to hold it down, but Kiyoshima will get in with the frag. Actually, I didn't think they were going to be able to get into the spawn site, but right now they're just plowing through Hellraisers. Hart's trying to get that second frag, not really succeeding. Still a 4v2. This should be very winnable for the Terrace team. And I thought it was overconfident and stupid of them to go into this side, but right now they're proving me wrong. Dozier 1v3, what's 1v4?
Oh my god.
Second one, gonna go in for all the glory right now. Dozier, can he make this happen?
Here he goes, trying to catch the flanker there in SF. Pulls out the pistol, looking for the shot, switch to the M4 on the ground. Takes down SF, one more player left. Kyoshima, one-on-one, does he have time? The bomb is ticking way too fast at this point. Yeah. Despite the heroic effort of Dozier, it will not be enough to save him and his team. 14-8 now, Hellraisers. They are doing such a good job trying to claw their way back from almost impossible odds against the French team Clan Mystik. But the end is nigh. Only two more rounds for that 16-round victory. So that is a harsh reality for Hellraisers.
Yeah. Their backs are against the wall right now. And they're just sitting in spawn just talking about it. It's gonna be one from us coming up. So right now they're saying we're gonna play some of our chips in, but then we're gonna save the rest of them. Right now, actually, Dozy the only one with money. They bought all of armor. So my call is completely wrong and very stupid. So forget what I just said. And Clan Mystik right now, they're on the verge of getting those 15 rounds. Those magical 15 rounds. Only one round to go, and then they are the winners. Let's see if they can make it happen.
That's a great start from Kucha, though. The problem is that they need guns. They have the armor, they just don't have the guns. And that's what they want, really. That's how they're kind of deciding to play this. Kucha makes the crucial frag here.
They
cannot get the weapon. So really interesting here. What are they going to do? Clan Mystik know that they're hurting for money. They're hurting for the buy. They're just going to rush all men in to B once again. Kucha takes down another player. There is the response from SF, though. Clan Mystik sweeping on into the site. It's actually a 3-on-3. This is very, very, very possible now for Hellraisers to take this back.
Only one kid, and that's on Markov. And one of his teammates very slow through his CT spawn. They can retake from all three angles right now. But only one AK, two pistols, one flashbang. And let's see here, Markov moves in. DMX trying to do the damage here. As Dozier comes into construction. Two players here. Sees one of the nice headshots from Dozier. Goes for that second. Can he pick it up right now? Moving in. GMX, Hearts. Dozier coming in from the back though. Can he get that last shot? But he's not going to have enough HP. And he's going to run away with the AK-47.
Nice.
Gets a kill, but runs away.
Oh no.
And loses the weapon.
Heartbreaking.
Oh, heartbreaking, really. And that is 15-8 match point, tournament point. For Clan Mystik, the Frenchmen on the verge of defeating Hellraisers 2-0 in the grand final.
And Clan Mystik can taste that $1,300, like filling up their bank accounts right now. Money to spend at Katowice, I'm sure. And here we go. Kyoshima messed up the flash there, but they're just going to go in for another B push. They feel the B is working,
so why
not just keep going with it?
So confident right now. They just believe that nothing can go wrong right now. And that can be either really good or really bad. And right now I think it's really good for them. They tried this the other time around and it actually worked out, even though it was not really the right thing to do. It happened though, and it went good for them. Let's see here now. They are kind of spreading out now, not choosing to go directly for the B push, not really feeling it.
This is interesting because this can be a really easy situation for Hellraisers to go. We've seen some guys at B, they've been really liking the B, just everyone rotate to B, but they're actually holding still at A, which I actually think is a very patient and very experienced play. You need a lot of experience to be able to make that call, but it looks like it will be B regardless. So it's going to be a 5-on-2 situation against a very bad weapon situation for Hellraisers, and Clan Mystik, again, sweeping on through. Kucha goes down. Kenny S executes him, looking to execute one more in Markloff, tapping away at Dozier. Dozier, though, able to bring the frag, but there's so much work.
Angel, can he pick up this frag here? He gets it, actually, and that's a 2v2, but Dozier goes down, so Angel has to save the entire round himself, and he will go down.
There it is.
And that is GG.
So 16-8. My goodness, we have ourselves a champion of the GSL Egamingbets Cup. It is Clan MYSTIK. As you said so rightly, Riz, they managed to actually be the victor in a tournament where we had NIP and we had HELLRAISERS. So massive props to Clan MYSTIK, sending home a massive statement with a very, very convincing victory in this grand final against their opponents, HELLRAISERS. Clan MYSTIK, they have a very bright future ahead of them, and I am definitely liking the fact that HELLRAISERS have rebranded themselves almost, because there was a lot of negativity, I think, associating their lineup with Asana Dragons, the name. But they did defeat NIP just yesterday, so the future looks good for them as well at Katowice.
Future looks good for CSGO right now, as all yes. teams are kind of like beating each other individually, and that is really what we need coming into another 250k tournament. The biggest tournament right now for the game, and the biggest in a long time if you take away the one at DreamHack just before. But yeah, we really need teams that can beat each other individually. We don't need another 87-0 map win like NIP had back in the day. And I'm really excited for Katowice. This is just a perfect intro.
Certainly it is. And guys, that means it's over. We've had a very long road here. An awesome few days of CS, starting out with awesome dominance from NIP. They got shut down eventually. And then eventually we had Clan MYSTIK making it happen. So thanks so much for watching. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks to GSL and eGaming guys for supporting the tournament, hosting it, and all the admins on their side as well. And of course, thanks to you, Riz, for coming in and saving me, commentating with me here today for this awesome game. Thanks so much, Risk.
No problem, man. Anytime.
We'll have to see you again here on Face It TV. But I think that's it from us here tonight, guys. So bye-bye.